What's up, YouTube? This is Michael G Crypto. Today, we're going to be taking a look at SafePal, specifically SFP slash USDT. And I'm going to be doing a complete top-down analysis, which means we'll be taking a look at SafePal from a monthly aspect, followed by a weekly aspect, then a daily aspect, then a four-hourly aspect, and finally an hourly aspect to give us a better idea of what exactly is happening and to give us the best entry. So for SFP, what I'll do is I'll examine SFP first from a monthly aspect, and I'll do that right now. Okay, so for the month of February and March, as you guys can clearly see, SFP has made massive gains towards the upside. SFP has made a total of 12,539% gains in a matter of 2 months. And I have not seen this yet for any coin in a matter of 2 months to make 12,000 gains. So this is quite unusual for a coin to do within 2 months, okay? 12,000 gains in 2 months, which is quite crazy. Now, on the weekly aspect, we go to SFP to see exactly what's happening. And over here, we can see that SFP has made a massive high towards the upside. We've come back down, retested. We made another high as well. And now we're coming down to retest potentially a support zone. So what I'll do here is I'll mark off the structure from the bottom of the impulse wave to the top of the impulse wave. And we'll see exactly how far we're coming down to retest. And over here, as you see, there are different zones of the Fibonacci zone. There is the 382, the 0.5, the 618, and the 786. These zones are referred to as support zones. The main zone over here is the 0.5 and the 618. So what I'll do right now is I'll mark off the 0.5 and the 618, which is located right over here. And the 0.5 and the 618 is referred to as the golden zone, which is why I marked it off. The weekly candlestick, which closed about 5 hours ago, has closed a doji candlestick. And that is a long wick at the top, a long wick at the bottom, and a really small body in the middle. A doji candlestick basically means that the bulls and bears were fighting and it has come to a nice balance and equilibrium. But doji candlesticks at a major support or a major resistance zone are also reversal candlesticks as well. So we do have a doji at a support zone, which has already hit the 50, but it yet hasn't hit the 618. So that is still a possibility. Now on the daily aspect, what I'll do is I'll try to mark off some structure of exactly what's happening. Okay, so here, what I'll do is I'll get a trend line out from the bottom to the top and I'll mark off this area. So as you see, this trend line has hit it once, twice. It nearly hit it a third time, but it didn't quite do so. Okay, so this is located right over there. Also on the above zone, I'll mark off another trend line from the top of the structure to the bottom, and I'll try to get as many touches as possible. Okay, perfect. So as you see over here, it's hit it once, it has hit it twice, it's hit it nearly three times, and now a fourth time. Okay, so it's hit it three times and now a fourth time. And that's exactly where SFP is doing. Every time SFP has hit the bottom, which is done twice, it's made a move towards the upside. Every time it's hit the upside, once, twice, three times, it's made a move towards the downside. Now, what I'll also do is I'll mark off the horizontal zone, which is located right over here. Okay, so right now, SFP is making a type of wedge structure or a type of triangle structure. Generally, what this means, it means that price action is being squeezed in this area, and there's a lot of buying happening in this area as well. And a lot of taking up of orders in the lower support zone. Also, if you look down at the volume chart below, we can see that volume has been decreasing substantially since the beginning, since this massive move towards the upside. We can see that volume has been decreasing towards the lower side. What does that have? What does that mean? That means that as volume decreases, if anybody puts in a large amount of sum, SFP will go drastically in that direction. Okay, so this is a $300 million coin. And if you look at the circulating volume, which is seen trading volume over here, 46 million. If anybody comes in with another 20 to 30 million, a whale, then SFP can definitely fly towards the upside or fly towards the downside, whether or not that whale is longing or shorting. Okay, so volume is decreasing. So an increase in volume will make massive, drastic moves for SFP. So that's a good thing, in fact, if volume is decreasing within a wedge or a triangle structure. Now, what I'll do is I've marked out the top of the structure, I've marked out the bottom of the structure. What does this mean for us? And how can we enter this trade? We can enter this trade in a number of ways. The first way is if you just want to hodl, you can hodl at the bottom of the structure over here, okay? Which is approximately at 2.5, Okay, so that's a good area to hodl if you just want to hodl and you don't want to look at it. But I'm here to give you the best entry. So this would be the best entry for SFB. Essentially, what we want SFB to do is to see this trend line above. We want a clear break of the uptrend line, a retest to go higher. And this will be our perfect entry for SFB. Okay, this is what we require SFB to do. Either it can happen now, or it can happen with another move towards the downside, and then a break and a retest to go higher. Okay, and if you make a move towards the downside, we also have this trend line support zone, which is one support zone. We have the 618, which is two. We have a horizontal zone, which is three. So there's three areas why this lower area is considered a strong support area. Okay, so the lower area is also a good area to buy if we go there. However, the top trend line has been holding price action down. So if you have a break above the trend line and a retest, this would also be considered a good entry over here. Okay, so I'll mark off the entries as basically a break and a retest showing massive rejection. Or you can wait for it to go lower over here and buy up some more SFB. However, this does not confirm a break of the structure. A break of the structure is determined after we break above the trend line, retest, and upon retesting, we have to find rejection of the structure. Okay, so something I don't like with SFP is the fact that we have leakage over here. Okay, and generally price tends to react to this leakage or this candlesticks that is seen above. So if we were to break above, we can definitely see a reaction to this leakage. As you've seen, when we come back to the retest, we have to wait for strong candlestick rejection off this trend line in order to enter. Now, the bear scenario for SFP is basically a break of the lower support zone to go lower. And our lower region will be right over here, okay, which is 2.1608. Now, what I'll do is I'll repeat everything I just said, but I'll keep it under 2 minutes so you get a quick summary of what I just said. And then I'll move on to the fundamental aspect and then the sentimental aspect to give you a complete analysis of what SFB really is. Okay, so we'll start on the monthly aspect. And as I've already mentioned, on the monthly aspect, SFB has made massive moves towards the upside in a matter of 2 months. SFP has made about 12,000% of moves, which is an insane amount of moves within a matter of 2 months. On the weekly aspect, if you look at the weekly aspect, we can see right now that SFP is having a pullback and we have closed with a doji candlestick at a support zone, which is considered a bullish structure to have at a support. On the daily aspect, if you look at the daily aspect, we can see that the lower trend line has been touched twice. So the lower trend line is regarded as a support zone and the above area has been touched 4 to 5 times. Now, we could reject this area, and we could go lower. And if we go lower, we'd be retesting the previous support zone that has been retested once, twice, three times, four times in the past, a trendline support, and a 618 support. So this lower area is considered a strong support zone. If we were to come over here, there would be some buying power, and it's going to be seen on the 4 hour if we were to make this move down again. Our entry, our precise entry for this, which would confirm a breakout of the structure, is a break of the trendline and a retest of the trendline. If we were to break above the trend line, we'll most likely have a reaction to this leakage that is seen on the top over here. Once we have the reaction, we can come back over here to the trend line. And at that point in time, we have to wait for confirmation of candlesticks. Upon candlestick confirmation, then we can make our entry towards the upside. And our potential gains for SFP is quite large as well. If you take the height of the structure to the bottom of the structure, and if our entry is over here, if the breakout happens over here, let's say, from our current position, then SFP is going to this region, which is considered 4.587. Okay, and I'll be more conservative as well, and I'll tell you the immediate targets as well, which is at 3.92 and at 4.44. So now, if these areas were to hit from our area, from the bottom to the top of the structure, that is first a 26% gain to the immediate area. Our second area will be a 42%. And our final area will be of 47%. Now, there's a few reasons why I think SFP can go much higher than this, possibly giving us 100 to 200% gains. And I'll point them out right now. Okay, so it's very possible to go to $5, $6, even $7. Now, what is SFP? SFP, first of all, SafeVal, is a $332 million market cap coin. So it is extremely small in this market space. Okay, SFP is also ranked number 235. Now, because it is 332, it has a lot of room to grow, depending if the coin is actually a good coin, which is why we go to the website, and the website can be found over here, which is www.safepal.io. on safepal.io, we can go to safepal.io and we can see that SFP actually provides hardware. And what does it provide? It provides wallets, right? So it protects your seed from water, fire, or corrosion. So these are like, these are very waterproof wallets. They're fireproof wallets, in fact, as well, corrosion proof. So these are proper wallets with leather casing and everything. So they do have a working product. They even have an online wallet with an app as well. Okay, now, what are their partners? SFP is the only hardware wallets that has partnered with Binance. So they have Binance, they have Litecoin partnerships, they have Uniswap, 1inch, JustSwap. So they have a bunch of partnerships as well. Now, if you go to the About page, which is seen at the top of the homepage over here, and we open that up, we can see exactly what SFP is about. SafePal is dedicated to providing a secure and user-friendly crypto management platform for the masses to secure and grow their crypto assets safely and conveniently. It is the first hardware wallet invested and backed by Binance. Okay, they're also in over 80 countries, and they have over 10,000 digital assets, and the product updates every 2 to 3 weeks, and it's been founded in the year of 2018, and the roadmap is also clearly printed out for us. Okay, and everything is seen over here. Now, what interests me about SFP as well, apart from all of this, is the fact that if you look at their community, we can see that SFP has 138,000 members on the Telegram group. They have over 100,000 members on a coin that is worth only 300 million in market cap. Okay, so their community is massive. And as of now, they have 16,000 members that are online. So it is a very large community, which means they have a lot of marketing for this product. As well as if we go down and we go to their Twitter handle as well, and we open up the Twitter handle, we can also see that SFP has 283,000 followers. So they have 283,000 followers, and they have 138,000 members on Telegram. And they're very active on Twitter as well, which means that a $300 million market cap, which is extremely small, has potential to go a lot higher than its current value. Okay, and this was the fundamental aspect. Now let's go to the sentimental aspect and see what the large investors are currently doing. And if you go to SFP under Binance Futures trading data, we can see right now that there is a more larger long to short ratio. On the 4-hour period, we can see that there's a 2.15 to 1 long to short ratio. Over here, it's a 1 is to 1 long to short ratio by the top trader long short ratio positions. And over here at the bottom, there's 2.98, which is basically a 3 is to 1 long short ratio. So there is more longs happening than shorts in terms of the large investors and what they're doing. Okay, so at this moment of time, I'm waiting to see what will happen with SFP. If it comes down here and we show a nice 4-hour candlestick rejection, since that is considered very low, I might decide to buy up some SFP at that point of time. If that doesn't happen, I'll still wait and allow a break of the structure and a retest in order to go higher. But our targets are evident, and those are much higher areas as well. And actually, one thing which I forgot to point out as well is the fact that SFP also has a ton of events coming out at the end of the month. And this would correlate with the fundamental analysis for SFP. Okay, SafePal. So if you go to CoinMarketCal and you type in SFP, which is SafePal, we can see that SafePal has 1, 2, 3, 4 events at the end of March, and four events at the end of April, and 2 events at the end of June. Okay, so it does have a lot of events coming up in the near future, which is the end of the month, which is after 2 to 3 weeks, which gives us an incentive for the price to go towards the upside as well. Okay, so this was my complete analysis of SFP. I went through the technical aspect, I went through the fundamental aspect, and then finally, I went through the sentimental aspect. So if you guys enjoy analysis like this, and you haven't already subscribed to the channel, feel free to subscribe below. I make a video on a daily basis. And again, this channel is specifically to give you guys the best entries. That way you guys can make the maximum amount of profits from this channel. Okay, so again, thank you for watching, and have a good day.